One of the things we stress every day is to work against press man coverage with our escape moves. We've used quite a few props. We actually buy some boxing gloves so that the coach or the defensive back doesn't get his hands and elbows all beat up. What we're going to try to do is incorporate some various moves with the swat and punch and the swat and swim, and we'll give you a few examples coming up here. Okay, you want to come up here, Bobby? Give you a little bit of an example as you're coming. I'm going to line up, have the defensive back line up inside. I want to start with my outside foot up. I want to always attack technique to make him take a step inside to fear my release of the inside. At the same time, I have my attack arm up in my stance, as we stressed earlier. My aiming point is going to be between his elbow and his tricep. I'm going to actually want to get a swat there, and I want to actually turn him, and then I want to punch through, limiting my hitting surface by turning my body, and then I can bring my arm down to knock those back arms. If they come through, I'll knock them down as I'm going through. So if we went through this just in a slow motion type look, I'm going to attack the technique. I'm going to go for that elbow there as I've turned him. All right, I'm going to punch through, and then I'll bring my arm back through if there's any hand still standing. Pretty much a 1-2 move. I learned this from an old defensive NFL defensive line coach that I was fortunate enough to coach with in my earlier years, and it stayed with me, and we incorporated it every day. It's pretty much a 1-2 as you're going through. And we'll give you a few examples of the student athletes doing their thing.
Took the arm with you.
But you want to knock it that way, and then you're coming through.